Yes.
What up, YouTube? It's your boy Riz Ill, and I'm back on the channel with another one. And today we are going to be reacting to Lyrical Lemonade's EMINEM GNAT. I'm not sure whether they were the ones responsible for the direction or the funding of this music video that EMINEM did for his song GNAT, or why it's not on his YouTube page, but it's here. The music video is here, and we're going to take a look at it from that. This was suggested to me by someone on WhatsApp, and a friend of mine, and I wanted to react to the lyric video first to truly see what he's saying and how he's putting the lyrics together. Because as a songwriter myself, it's more of like a school, like a classroom session for me, like to get to know like how he spaced his words, like the breathing, the cadence, the way he put things together, the way he stretched syllables, you know, different aspects to it. I wanted to react to the lyrical thing because it's for me, it's more of like a writer's thing, you know, rather than, you know, to see, oh my god, what he said. Like I've learned a lot from Eminem. Eminem was probably the first rapper I properly paid attention to in my entire life. I started listening to Eminem in like primary school. So yeah, man, I'm excited to see this and excited to hear what he said, because shit, man, he's one of the reasons I rap today, man. He was truly a big influence on my life. So let's take a look at what he did for EMINEM GNAT.
See, these bars are like COVID. Bars are like COVID. You get them right off the bat. Infected with SARS and Corona. Like you took a bite off of that. Then it goes from Martian to human. That's how the virus attacks. They come at me with machine guns. Trying to fight off a gnat. Still stacking my chips, hoes. Higher than Shaq on his tiptoes. Top the Empire State Building. This shit is like child's play children. I will annihilate, kill them. I fuck around and pile 8 million dead little juveniles. Wait, children, I'll await my trial. Nate Tilden. What then? Ain't nothing you say could ever trump. Mike Pence. So get killed, yeah. If you're hypersensitive, I wasn't referencing the vice president. Chill, yeah. I mean, my penmanship at times tends to get ill. Violence, but with skill. That's why I hints when I write hints with the mic and pencil getting killed. Yeah.
That part is always like a tricky situation. That's when you truly know you're in the zone and you're writing something like that, and then you do like a 3 second switch up, like 3 seconds into like whatever. It's not exactly 3 seconds, but 3 seconds or a couple words into the maybe the third line or so that you were gonna use before you get to the fourth line of the rhyme. You switch it up, and then you use it not only to switch it up and get to another rhyme scheme, but to switch up the flow. And it's so beautiful when that happens when you're writing, but you also don't know, like you almost have to be very careful about how you finish it. You saw how he finished it, that, you know. He just finished it like, he just like threw it up in there and then he just left it there. You know, it's always tricky because the switch up is so clean. You always want to finish off on a good note. So that's, I like that, man. I know this. Maybe, I don't know whether y'all want to like judge me or whatever. Or maybe y'all think I don't know what I'm talking. But I know this because I studied it from him, man. He's the first person I ever studied. Like, whatever I'm explaining or saying right now, I don't know whether it makes sense or not, but I know this because of people like, of him mainly, you know, so yeah.
And I'm still riding, die for the squad. Yeah. So you know which side that I'm on. If a battle line's ever drawn, but if I get involved, it'll be like canines in a brawl. But not similar to Mike, pick it off. Cause even if I don't have a dog in the fight, they ain't never gonna get rid of the fight in the dog. Got stripes like a tiger.
Okay. That's what I like to call like translating line, you know, where like you hit a punchline, but then let me just explain. You saw it, even though I don't know whether, I'm sure there's a bunch of you that think very deeply when you're paying attention to this shit, but as a writer, that's, you know how it feels when you come up with a line like that, man. But fuck it, what do I know? My music hasn't popped off, has it?
So you might get mauled, the mic in the palms like claws, like swing right for your jaw and rip it off with one swipe of the paw. Is you still on my dick or nah? If I suck, your wife is a straw. I'm sick and I'm not gonna cover my mouth next time that I cough. Cause see, these bars are like COVID. Bars are like COVID. Get them right off the bat. Get them right off the bat. It was SARS and Corona. Like you took a bite off the bat. Then it goes from Martian to human. That's how the virus attacks. They come at me with machine guns. Get with the plane trying to fight off a gnat. Yeah. They got that dopey sense to me. It's like pneumonia symptoms of contracting COVID instantly, which is what separates my flow from theirs so that no one gets even close to this to pose a risk to me. So vocalistically, that's social distancing. Yeah. Flow going viral, you best stay strapped with that Lysol and get way back, hit that Pine Sol and that Ajax, cause this dry cough is just like football umpires calling a playback. Bitch, back the fuck up like 15 yards, these rhymes call for a face mask. Another 14-day quarantine, they're cordoning off everything. This shit looking like a horror scene, like me metaphorically. Damn, cause them stay-at-home orders seem like they just keep getting more extreme. Who knows?
That's what I don't like about nowadays. I was talking to my friend about this yesterday when he was suggesting all of this. And he was talking to me about like all these different things, and he's saying how he likes the current state of where Eminem is right now. He doesn't think like it's changed or it doesn't smack as it used to. He's like a hardcore fan, like me. I'm a true believer in Eminem. I'm a fan. I can say that, but I'm not like as like hardcore, or let me just say I'm not as like blind, like following like everything is dope as. Like, I'm just blindly following, you know. When I see something is off, I see something is off. And what I see is off is Eminem, his skills have been solidified through time. And he is an elite rapper, but the problem is, it's his versatility. He's living in a time where the current beats that they're using, it doesn't suit the bass style that he comes from. I don't know if any of you have detected that, but when he's using, like, some of these trap beats and all of that, his cadence isn't like 100%, it doesn't 100% fit the current style that we like new age rappers use. And even though he has the flows, it's like he has no swagger in it, you know. He just has the flows. There's no like swagger in it, like a swagger in his cadence and all of that, and the way he like flows and the way he stretches words. There's no swagger in it when he does it, so he sort of has to do all like, hey man, I'm trying to explain it to y'all, bro, because my mind is going wild. Because I've been thinking about this for a while, because I download, like, the albums that Eminem drops, and I listen to it, like, I try to listen to it, but then I always feel like he's not, like, what he used to be. Not because he isn't dope anymore, but because his style and his sound is just not suited to his to this day and age right now. And I know, yeah, a lot of y'all will say this day and age, the music is whack anyway. We are complacent, like, hit songs that come out of nowhere are usually, like, trash, and they're just, like, moments in time, you know, they just trend for funny reasons. And Eminem is truly, like, a great, and he's truly, like, puts in that work, but compared to when, like, the modern day, when we modern day rappers, when we actually do it right, compared to, like, us and when we actually do it right, Eminem, he's losing off of swag alone, bro. He's not losing completely, he's just, like, struggling off of, like, the swag in him alone, you know, because back in the day he was most, because he was a rebel, you know, he came with this new sound, the industry didn't know what to do with him, and he fucked everyone up. But nowadays, with everything that's going on, bro, he's a little bit out of place in that area. He's not out of place completely, because he is a genius, but he's a little bit out of place in terms of that area of like character, the character that you have to have in terms of these songs alone. But that's just my feelings. Leave your comments below. And yeah, man, that's just how I feel. Let's finish this thing.
When it's night Maryland, like Monroe, Norma Jean, still got that heroin, lyrical drip with that morphine and that Thorazine, cause I'm so fucking dope, and you're a fiend, and that's the one thing that hasn't changed, no, some semblance of normalcy, but I might need that hydrochloroquine, cause I got that, yeah, dark horse, I'm a nightmare, mom fed me Valium light air, thought that's why they called it a high chair, whoa, I got a contact like eyewear, whoa, wait a minute, bitch, let me lie here, 2020 hindsight is my side mirror, every year you drop the ball like Times Square, my hair trigger whenever I get an idea, like, fuck. Now my name rings out like a sponge mop. My drip was a drop in the bucket, so that gunshot you just heard just now in that one spot just came from the 9 mil that I just got. That's big bucks, and I got a full money clip, and I'm loaded. I ain't even mean to go the fuck off. And I'm feel totally inappropriate with an opiate, groping it while I'm holding it like a trophy. I'm hoping a little codeine will give me OD, and whoa, everything is slow. I begin to floating. I know that I'm getting loaded, the pin exploded. Hiroshima with the flows of utopia with the dope. I'm an OG, I'm like the goat here to get your goat. Little bit of sodium, it's the salt when I'm at the podium. Bitch, I throw holy camoli. I'm in a zone with the shit I'm on, getting modium in a commode because nobody's even close. Your petroleum to plutonium, you're a phony. I'm at the crib, but your hoe got her at the pole like voting with no clothing, stripped down to a toe ring. And here we go with the gloating. I got my nose in the air like a Boeing. Then I got into a little bit of an argument with her, so I took a little lick of a line of penitent. Then I hit it with a motherfucking ottoman and bitter. Then I shot her in a liver, delivered it to the bottom of the river. But I'm probably gonna jump in the water with her with a lot of money, cause I got a lot of it. And when it come to dripping, I be stopping like 100 miles an hour, never running out of either one of them. I gotta get it, cause these bars are like COVID. Like, go get him right off the bat. Get him right off the track. It was SARS and Corona. Like, you took a bite off of that. Yeah. And it goes from Martian to human. From Martian. Yeah. That's how the virus attacks. They come at me with machine guns. Like, trying to fight off a net. Fight off a net. Fight off a net. Fight off a net.
That was beautiful. That was beautiful. Let me just be a smart ass and presume what maybe anyone who'd come with an argument to what I said would say about, like, my reaction after that. They'd be like, ah, you said Eminem, he's maybe lacking in, like, maybe swagger in his, like, his cadence or character when he does these things, but you are jamming to him. I was jamming to him because of the flow. I wasn't jamming to him because my opinion changed, you know. There's a difference between, like, what Eminem does is mostly execution. But the way people, like, get, like, bigger, honestly, nowadays, bigger hit songs than him, whether you like it or not, you know, because I know a lot of people, like, I know this is an uncomfortable thing. It's even an uncomfortable thing for me to say because I miss that age, because that age of, like, Eminem was so big for me because he truly showed kids like me who are different that it's okay to be different and it's okay to be angry. You know, some people say, ah, you angry for nothing, you this, this, and that. Just accept the crap that the world gives you. And Eminem was like, to me, he was like, no, you don't just accept the world, the crap that the world gives you, you fight back. So it is an uncomfortable situation for me to say. But, like, the reason why they're beating him is just off of the characters people come up with in their songs alone. Like, Eminem is just, like, his character is not suited to, like, a lot of the new age shit a lot of the new age shit that's out there, bro. You see, it's hard for me to really say. It's just not suited. His flows are there and everything he does is there. But you even see, like, parodies on the internet where people are, like, they easily, like, imitate him and they imitate exactly how he's going to say in his rhyme scheme. Like, na 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 na. I took a matchstick and a little plastic and I took a plastic. You know, it's very easy for them to imitate that shit because where you lack the reason why I put emphasis on character is when you're writing, character allows for easy versatility when you're writing music. So as long as you've got character that suits the sound and the day and age and you've settled into it and you're comfortable in it as not just a rapper but a writer is essential. That's why I always emphasize on the fact that rappers should write their own shit because they need to develop that character. As long as you have that shit, you can easily bend the flows and bend the will of the song to whatever you want it to be. And when you like that character, you sort of start doing stuff that's damn near so repetitive that people won't be thinking, how did he come up with that? They'll just be thinking, ah, we've heard this before. This is how he does it all the time. We can come up with it too. It's easy. No, they won't be thinking that, yo, when he came up with that shit, yo, my perspective of how to approach that sound totally changed. You know, and I'm about to piss a lot of people off, but that's the difference between, no, fuck. I want to bring Drake into this, but Drake also, like, he works with people, that's the thing, whereas Eminem, he's a pure writer, that's the thing. Let's just live in a world where Drake, everything he did was actually his, right? In terms of that shit, the way he puts things, the way Drake orchestrates things or puts things together is the way probably Kanye West, like, produces music. In terms of the writing, in terms of writing alone, because Drake isn't a producer, right? But in terms of a writer, because Drake is a writer, you know, he's not like a Jay-Z or Eminem where they'll just, like, off of the bat, they'll just start spitting. Like, you saw all those old, like, Eminem videos where he just starts rapping off the bat and then he just starts using words and then start coming up with, like, crazy phrases. and a crazy storyline within his raps, and then he just keeps going and going. I love that shit because I learned from that shit so much. Oh my god. But like, the difference between like that and what Drake has right now is, fuck man, I'm nerding out, bro. I'm so sorry, I'm nerding out. But let's just pretend like we're in a world where Drake, he came up with all his shit, and like he's just like Eminem, but in his own way, in terms of like all the stuff that we've heard so far. There was no Quentin Miller, there was no These Secret Guys. If we were to live in that world, the way Drake has orchestrated it, like how I said, the way it's like how Kanye produces music is, he knows how to put it together in the direction where it's almost like a movie. Whereas Eminem, it's literally just a play, a script that repeats like night after night. Like, it's still beautiful. It's still a beautiful play. It's still a beautiful script, but there's no sequel and there's no change-ups. You know what I'm saying? Because he's stuck in this formula, honestly speaking, where he has to sort of use the same skill set because it's the only way he's managing the current change in time and the way people are doing things. And he's only beating these kids that are out there who are coming out, not the ones who are like whack or like they're complacent or they don't really rap, but the ones who truly like they're getting after it and they've settled into this town because this is their day and age. They were born into this. He's only beating or competing with them off of skill alone. And skill alone isn't enough. You need to have character. So that's just me and my opinion. I hope you didn't get lost in that. I hope you don't judge me because that's how me, I've truly thought and analyzed this stuff and like compared it to like, cause I listen to this shit and then I go and then when I write, like when you hit like a stroke of genius when you're writing shit, you just start like thinking about, okay, Eminem did it like this or Cole did it like this and all of that, and then they hit the switch up like this. It's like mathematics. It's literally like mathematics, except like mathematicians, bro. It's literally like how mathematicians explain like how they do maths, you know, when we like, ah, man, how do you do this maths thing? It's so hard. Writing music is literally like that. It's just an algorithm that's in your head that you just know. You just know when you hit that point of genius, you just know. So, yeah, that was me. That was my reaction to Nat. I'm sorry for that over-explanation. I see I've taken your time. But, yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and I hope I made sense. I hope I made sense because this is how my mind explodes when I'm listening to this type of stuff and like truly like breaking down in my head. Actually, this is just like maybe 30% or 40% actually of everything that goes on in my head in terms of this music shit. But yeah, have a good day. And Daniel, thank you. Thank you for this.
Me and I am in a huddle before the enemy crumbled. Then to the moon took a shuttle. I never fumble. Legacy, all that I juggle. Almost depleted my bundle. Within the jungle, I rumble. This ain't no regular tumble. Fuck up a muzzle. Number of shots at a couple. Me and my bars are a couple. This ain't no regular hustle.